knowing how much you can haul, how much you can tow is very important. It's important if you're looking to buy a truck, especially you want to make sure you do your calculations correctly, especially if you're looking to haul a piece of equipment or haul something on a regular basis. You want to make sure it's set up properly to do so. It's also important if you're borrowing somebody else's truck and trailer, you'll make sure that it's legal and safe and you're not getting in trouble. But ultimately, this is important so that you're staying safe on the road and you're keeping other drivers safe as well. Just because a truck can tow a certain amount of weight doesn't mean it should necessarily. Because you have to remember, all this weight that you're carrying, you have to be able to stop safely. You also have to be able to negotiate turns safely. I'm sure you all remember the commercials years ago. I think it was a Toyota Tundra pulling an airplane. Well, that's all well and good, but it's not going fast, first of all, and it has to be able to stop that weight as well. So you got to keep all that in mind. Calculating it is really not that hard. It can sound a little confusing. There's a lot of different numbers, a lot of different abbreviations, combinations, gross vehicles, payload, different things. We're just going to go over the basic procedure to calculate how much you can haul legally and safely for a truck. Today's example, we're going to use a Ford F-550 dump truck. It's a 2015. Now, whether it's a Ford, a Chevy, or a Dodge, the information is pretty much going to be the same or found in the same spot. Usually, on the inside of the door is where they're going to have a sticker. You're going to have a bunch of information on it. Some of the information is important for this video. Other things are just noted. But the number you want to concentrate on is your GVWR, your gross vehicle weight rating. It's usually found up here at the top. In this case, it's 19,500. Also, there's usually a sticker that'll say your tire pressures and ratings, which we'll discuss a little bit later on in the video. That's also important in your axle ratio for hauling safely, whether it's stone or cargo in the truck or hauling a trailer as well. So once you get that first number, like I said, in this case, it's 19,500. You want to write that down. That's the total weight that this truck can have on this single axle and in that front single axle at any times. This truck has dual rear wheels, so it's going to be set up a little differently than some. That's something else to keep in mind too. This is a diesel. Diesel is going to weigh more. They're going to have heavier suspension. So this truck's going to be set up to the haul a bit more than, say, a gas or a single rear wheel or something like that. There's many variations, and it's just, they're not all cut and dry. That's why you got to look at this sticker to find this out. The next number you want to find out is your curb weight, which is essentially your empty weight. Now you might be thinking to yourself, why isn't that number on that sticker? Wouldn't that be easier? Yes, it would be, but the main reason they do that is because when the truck comes from the plant, it's just a cab and a chassis. There's no bed on it. At that point, it can be manufactured sometimes per order, whether it's a flatbed, a pickup truck bed, a dump truck bed. Like in this case, this has an aluminum bed. But there are many different variations there. So they just send a cab and chassis. So that's why they just put the sticker on as far as that number. What that truck is rated, no matter what bed you put on, that's the most it could ever weigh out with that cab and chassis and that suspension setup. The best way to do this is to just go to a local scale and weigh the truck. It's best to have a full tank of fuel and your normal accessories, your toolbox full with whatever tools you usually have. But it's best to go to a local scale to get these numbers. It can be a local concrete plant, sometimes a scale, an asphalt plant. Definitely a local stone quarry will have one, because anytime you go to get stone, you have to pull on there emptied, get your empty weight. And after you get loaded with stone, you'll pull on there and they calculate your exact tonnage that they put on you. Also, a landscape yard might have a scale if they're a little bit bigger. And another place is a scrap yard will have a scale as well. Some of these places you can just say, hey, I just want to get a curb weight. Do you mind if I pull on your scale? They'll let you on, no big deal. Some places there might be a very small fee. I don't know, maybe $5 or $10. Either way, it's worth it. Once you get this number of your curb weight, your empty weight, it's a good idea to write it down somewhere in your truck, right in your book. Put it on the dash, put it a couple places so you don't lose this number. Yes, it's going to vary a little bit depending how much fuel you have, how many different accessories you carry. But that's why if you have a full tank of fuel with you and pretty much your maximum setup. That way you can, you're going to be safe. So once you have your gross vehicle weight rating, then your empty weight, you want to subtract those numbers, and that will give you how much you can tow or haul legally. So then if you're looking to haul a trailer as well, this is known as your gross combined vehicle weight rating, GCWR, or sometimes they throw a V in there, gross combined vehicle weight rating. They say it different ways, but the C is what's important. The C is the combination weight. This is what the truck and the trailer can weigh when they're both loaded. That's the max the truck can haul safely with a trailer. This can be found usually online by going to the manufacturer's website, whether it's Ford, Dodge, whoever. A lot of RV sites also have this information as well. But you can always turn to your manual. They're going to have a section in the manual for towing. It's usually a generic section that'll list some different options like F-250, F-350, dual rear wheel, single rear wheel. You need to know what your truck is, whether it's gas or diesel, how many liters. So for here, we know we have got an F-550. It's not a gas. Diesel. So you come over here. Next column is the axle ratio, 4.3. Then the final column is the maximum gross combined weight rating. 35,000 pounds. But if we keep looking, there's one more column here. It's not a gas. .6 diesel. This axle ratio is 4.88, and it can either be 26,000 pounds or 35,000 pounds. Now that's a big difference there, but if you notice there's a little asterisk, requires optional gross combination weight rating package. So this is very important to know if your vehicle has that or not, because otherwise you might only be able to haul 26,000 pounds, which is just under CDL. Otherwise you're in need of CDL if you're set up with that package to be over that. Any vehicle that is 26,001 pound is going to require, or more, is going to require a commercialist driver's license. If you want to haul a trailer, you need a Class A. Something else to keep in mind, anything that's registered over 10,000 pounds, if you're looking to do interstate commerce, you're traveling across state lines, you're going to need a DOT physical card. It's every 2 years you have to go get a DOT physical. The price ranges, it's 60, 70, 80 bucks sometimes, but you need a physical card if you're over 10,000 pounds. If you're staying in your state, you want to get on your state's website, they're going to have different regulations. Some places it's 16,000 pounds, 17,000. It's going to vary a little bit from state to state, so make sure you check that out and know that as well. Also, it's going to give you information about Department of Transportation numbers and signage on the side of your truck, but that's all a topic for another day. So again, this is just your maximum gross combined weight rating. So say you've got a 12,000 pound trailer that you haul around. You want to add that to your 19,500 pounds. And that will give you 31,500, I do believe. Which is important because if you were gas, you wouldn't be able to haul that. You'd be illegal. And also, if you don't have this towing package, you'd be illegal as well. So you need to find out if you're not 100% sure if you have this towing package for sure what your rear axle ratio is, 4.88. A place to find this is going back to your sticker, the one we talked about as far as the tires. No, I'm sorry, up here it says axle and it gives you a code 8L. Now for this you'll need to get on Ford's website to determine what that code means. Why they do it this way, I'm not 100% sure. Maybe somebody can fill me in why that is. But if you get on their website or even a chat room, they will usually answer that question to tell you what the axle ratio is, so you can determine what you can then haul. So for this example, this is the 4.88. 35,000. It's legal to haul that trailer I was just talking about that's 12,000 pounds. Just something to keep in mind, especially if you have a smaller truck, a 450, a 350, a 250. They're going to have different combination weight ratings. You want to make sure that whatever the truck's rated at, whatever the trailer's rated at, is not over this limit. Because even if you're empty and you're towing a trailer that's over that limit, you get pulled over or wreck, you're going to get some fines. You could even potentially see some jail time. They don't mess around when it comes to being overweight or if you're over your registered weight rating, even if you're empty. Now you say, how are they going to know this? Well, sometimes they have scales. I've been pulled over just for simple DOT inspections numerous times, and they've never once pulled out a scale on me. It's just usually a generic check, lights, horns, simple things. Nothing's leaking. They might crawl under briefly. They've all been pretty simple. But I know of other guys that have been pulled over. They actually have a scale, portable scales they use, and they'll check your weight. And if you're overweight, you can get some big fines and a lot of trouble. And you have to sit there until the truck gets emptied so it can be hauled safely. That's something that can really eat up a lot of time and something that we don't always plan into our schedule. So just keep that in mind. So also on these stickers, we talked about the tire. This is what the truck is recommended to have. So you want to always just verify that it's the truck tires that are recommended. 225, 70, 19.5 in this case. These are what the manufacturer recommends. You want to make sure they're properly inflated, that they've got good tread and everything. This is something that usually the officers check too. They want to check that weight rating to make sure you're not going to be blowing a tire or snapping an axle. They want to make sure that you are as safe and legal as possible. Some hitches, especially the aftermarket ones, will have a sticker on them somewhere that'll tell you what they're rated at. That's another thing to keep in mind. Your trailer tongue weight on the truck is also going to count as weight on the truck itself. So maybe you've already got the truck loaded pretty heavy with something you've got a trailer on. That trailer weight is also going to add weight to your truck, so you want to make sure that your truck is not over that initial 19,500 that we talked about first. One last note that would probably be helpful to mention, especially if you're trying to calculate how much you can haul on your trailer alone. You want to basically copy the same process as finding out for your truck. Find the sticker on your trailer that has the GVWR. This is usually stamped on the tongue. You then want to find the weight of your empty trailer. You can probably go on the manufacturer's website and they'll probably have this listed. Just make sure that if you add any toolboxes or any extra features that you have this calculated in. If you go to a scale, this might be a little bit harder to do, but you could potentially weigh your empty trailer on a scale. And then you want to subtract those two numbers, and that will give you the amount of weight that you can actually haul on your trailer. Again, there's a lot of numbers and a lot of some math involved, but it's really not that complicated when you sit down and think about it. You always want to take your time to make sure that you are legal and safe. And if you have any questions, it's always best to get online and research it before you just go out there and haul and just hope for the best. You want to make sure you're hauling things legally and that you're being safe about it.